This is an ultimate step-by-step tutorial on setting up Jellyfin Media Server on Raspberry Pi 4. Hey guys, my name is KSK Ryle. In this video, I'm going to show you how to install the Jellyfin Media Server on Raspberry Pi 4 with hardware acceleration support. Now, this is a simple and best media server for home and can be built by yourself using Raspberry Pi 4 or Pi 3. So what exactly is Jellyfin? It's a simple media server that allows you to build your own media server with your content and stream across multiple devices within a network. It's like a volunteer-built media solution that puts you in control of your media. For example, let's say if you own a media content on DVDs like movies or music, you can create a media server and rip all the content on the server. This way, you can stream the content from multiple devices. Now, before starting this video, these are the prerequisites you need. A Raspberry Pi 4 or Pi 3, both works fine with this guide. An SD card of 32GB or higher, or SSD with at least 64GB. A decent power adapter. A physical computer running Linux, Windows, or Mac OS. And lastly, you need an Ethernet cable for internet connection. Now, on your computer running Windows or Mac OS or Linux, open a web browser and head over to this website. Download the Raspberry Pi Imager tool and install it. Then head over to this website and download the Raspberry Pi OS 64-bit. I'm going to use a non-GUI version or light edition that is easy to communicate with Raspberry Pi from a remote computer via SSH. Once it's done downloading the Raspberry Pi OS, open the Imager tool. Now connect the SD card or SSD to the computer to flash OS. I recommend SSD for faster speeds. This is where we install OS and store the media content for streaming. Now in this case, I'm using a 120GB SSD. Now anyway, choose OS. Select the custom image option and import the downloaded image file. Now select storage and choose your drive. Then select settings and enable the hostname and SSH. Set the password for the default user Pi. If you want to enable or set up a Wi-Fi connection for Raspberry Pi, type your network name and password over here. In my case, I will be using an Ethernet port for internet connection. Then save the changes and write an image to the USB drive. Once it's done flashing the OS, eject the SSD or SD card and insert it into the Raspberry Pi 4. Along with that, I'm going to connect the Raspberry Pi to a power source and Ethernet cable. That's it, time to turn on Raspberry Pi. The first boot will take less than 60 seconds. On your remote computer, open a terminal or command prompt and type this command to fetch the IP address of Raspberry Pi 4 assigned by the Wi-Fi router. Now in this case, this is the IP address of my Raspberry Pi. Now type SSH Pi and the IP address. You can also replace the IP address with raspberrypi.local and press the enter key. Accept the authentication key and type the password to log in. As you can see, I have connected to Raspberry Pi remotely via SSH. The first thing to do after connecting to Raspberry Pi via SSH is to increase the timeout limit of the remote session. To do so, type this command and scroll over here. Uncomment these two lines. For the client alive interval, set the value to 10,000. This will make the SSH connection stay active for 3+ hours. Once it's done, save the changes by pressing Ctrl+O. and pressing Ctrl X to exit from a text editor. Before installing a Jellyfin on Raspberry Pi, it's always recommended to set up a file sharing server. That way we can remotely copy and paste the media on the storage drive. To do so, first update the system by typing this command. Once it's done, install the Samba package by typing this command. Now type this command to create a directory named files inside media. Within a newly created folder, create two subfolders named movies and music. This is where we store media content. Now type these commands to set up a Linux permissions for the files directory. That way we don't end up facing any read and write issues. Now type this command and edit the Samba configuration file. Scroll to the bottom and add these lines to whatever you see over here. Once it's done, see the changes. Now set up a Samba password for the default user by typing this command. Now after that, type these two commands to restart the Samba services. It's time to test the NAS server. Open File Manager, choose Network, here you can see Raspberry Pi. Go ahead and log in with the username and password and connect to NAS. Voila, as you can see, both movies and music folders are visible. Using this file sharing method, you can remotely copy and paste the content hassle-free. I'm going to copy a video files and music to these folders. Once it's done, set up the NAS server on Raspberry Pi 4, it's time to set up a Jellyfin media server. To do so, type these commands one by one. You can find all the commands in the description of this video. Once it's done, type this command and make sure the Jellyfin server is running as a daemon. Now open any web browser and type the IP address of Raspberry Pi 4 or Pi 3 with port number 8096. And that's it. Now I have connected to the web interface of Jellyfin media server. It's time to configure the Jellyfin media server. Just go ahead, choose the language, then click on Next. Set up a username to access the Jellyfin server. The default username is Jellyfin and set up a password. Now choose to add a media library. We are going to link both movies and music folders to the Jellyfin Media Sabha. Once it's done, click on Next and leave the defaults. Make sure you have enabled this option to allow remote connection to the Jellyfin Sabha. Click on Next and finish configuring Jellyfin. Now this will take you to the login panel and type the username and password to login. Now you can see the content present inside movies and music directories across multiple devices. This is the best media server that you can build with your content. It's time to enable hardware acceleration on Raspberry Pi 4 to improve the speed of transcoding. Now, this will significantly improve the video playback. To do so, on the web interface, from the top left, click on the hamburger icon and choose Dashboard. Now select Playback, choose Hardware Acceleration, and use the V4L2 module for hardware accelerated performance. Once it's done, save the changes. Now back at the terminal, type this command to add Jellyfin user to the video group. Now type this command to edit the boot configuration file, then add these lines at the bottom. The first line increases the GPU memory, and the rest of the three lines overclock the Raspberry Pi 4. Keep in mind that overclocking is optional. You need a proper CPU cooler and better power supply to make the Pi work correctly. If you don't know what you're doing, remove these three lines. Once it's done, save the changes. There are some times when your Wi-Fi router restarts and the IP address will keep on changing for Raspberry Pi 4. As of now, in my case, this is the IP address assigned by the Wi-Fi router. I'm going to set the same as the static IP address. So next time, if my Wi-Fi router restarts, it will assign the same IP address for the Raspberry Pi 4. To set a static IP address, type this command to edit the DHCP configuration file. Add these lines at the bottom. If you notice, this is the pull range of my DHCP server, and this is the default gateway address to the Wi-Fi router. According to the pull range of your Wi-Fi router, you can set up a static IP address between this range. Once it's done, save the changes and reboot the Raspberry Pi 4. Now I can reconnect back to the Raspberry Pi 4 via SSH using the same IP address, and it works very well. Now upon rebooting, the Jellyfin Media Server will run automatically. And that's pretty much it. This is how you correctly set up a Jellyfin Media Server on Raspberry Pi 4. Let me know what you think about it in the comment section down below. Don't forget to check the description box for more information. Thanks for watching this video. This has been KSK Ryle. I will see you in my next one.